know, it's about a little over 5 years ago, a team of us got together and we worked on a vision for launching a nonprofit organization out of our church, and we did, and it's called Grace for Dover, and many of you support that, and you get our newsletter. But in that 5 year period, I became by default the executive director of Grace for Dover, and it was one of our goals was to hire an executive director. Now, I would have to put that hat down at some point, so we decided that we'd go on a search, and for I guess over the last 2 years, we were searching for an executive director. We searched high and low, and I do mean that. We searched the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere for an executive director, but the Lord, in His providence, had someone here in Dover that He was preparing, and it is now, as of May 2nd, Paige Baione is the executive director of Grace for Dover, and we're glad to have Paige with us. And Paige, would you come? Give us a word of greeting. Now, as maybe you recall this, but it was part of our initiative, the Advanced Generosity Initiative, to hire an executive director for Grace for Dover. So this is happening because of your generosity, because of what God has done in you, through you, that we have Paige before us today. Paige.
Thank you so, so much. It is absolutely through your generosity and the grace of God that Grace for Dover is doing such a good work in the city of Dover and surrounding the city of Dover. I want to thank you because I know that you have been praying. I know it was not just those that were on the committee that were praying, but you have all been so supportive in your prayers, in your finances, and in your time, in supporting the good work that Grace for Dover is doing. I have joked with Kenny and Tyler and others saying, you've been praying for a long time, and I'm really sorry I wasn't listening earlier. But the truth is, God's timing is always perfect. So the work that He was doing in preparing Grace for Dover to receive me, and the work that He was doing in me to receive His will and His plan for my life, and you know, me getting around to the point of saying, okay, no more of what I want. What do you want? The timing is perfect, and I do believe His timing is always perfect. You need to give a big applause to all of those who founded Grace for Dover and the incredible work in their spare time. Who has that? Especially not a full-time pastor and all of these wonderful people who have jobs and families and other things to devote their time to. But in their spare time, they've created an amazing organization. And I want to tell you, we are not just helping people find jobs. We are not just teaching people how to manage their money. We are not just helping families with children with disabilities and giving them nights with a night out for the parents where they can trust us to take care of their children. And we are not just educating people on living healthy lives in wholeness. We are bringing wholeness to all of them because we are giving them a hope that they are not going to find anywhere else. You can go to the public library and get help with a resume. You can go to many classes and learn how to manage your money. A lot of it you can even do by yourself online. So why Grace for Dover? Because in the process of that very real and intentional work, we are doing something else. We are giving hope. We are giving the hope that is found in Jesus Christ. And as I sat in on classes, I saw lives being transformed. I saw people in the process of learning how to find a good job to support their family realize that they themselves were made in God's image, that they have value and worth because they were made in God's image. I have seen people lay down burdens from their childhood or from their past and realize they do not need to be held down by their past or by any painful words that others may have said to them in the past, that they are a new creation. And that can only happen through faith in Christ. And those opportunities come because we have amazing people like you who are volunteering your time to come in and work one-on-one or with groups or to serve pizza at a respite night. It may seem like something so small. You may be wondering, how is serving pizza serving the gospel? It is. It absolutely is. And it's a beautiful thing to witness. I am so humbled that I get to be in this position. It was through much prayer, yours and my own, that God led me in this direction and told the committee, this is the one. And I am so humbled by that fact. I feel like a kid in a candy store. I get to do this every day. It's so exciting that I get to help people every day. And I get to grow this organization outside of the walls of this church. You've done an outstanding job doing what you've done here at Grace. And now we're going to extend that because we need more volunteers so we can help more people. I want us to get to a day where we don't ever have to turn anyone away and say, I'm sorry, but we don't have enough volunteers to add you to this class. Or, I'm sorry, but we didn't have time to train somebody to teach that class. Or, I'm sorry, but anything. I want us to say, yes, come. Let us help you. Let us walk this road together. Let us learn together and love together and live out the gospel of Jesus Christ together. So please join me in those prayers. Please continue to pray for those of us who are building Grace for Dover that will make the right decisions, God's decisions all along the way. Please pray for all of our volunteers who are working so hard and so tirelessly that they will continue to have the strength to do what they are doing. Of course, pray for our finances because it takes money to do these things. And please pray for all of our students and the clients that we serve that the gospel will reach their hearts and their souls and that their lives will be transformed. Thank you so much.